Jigawa, a land full of milk and honey, where rivers flow full of fish, fertile land, evergreen, in mind-blowing serenity. Are people ever so eager in pursuit of economic growth that investors are always welcome with open arms? Jigawa State, a state whose dream is fast becoming a reality.
We can raise Jigawa State to be a reference point in this country.
The Jigawa of our dream.
Becoming an economically viable state.
High standard of living.
We work hard to be able to force the world to reckon with us. They will be forced to know, yes, this is Jigawa.
Jigawa State has already achieved great success in creating an environment that is friendly for business.
With strong visionary leadership and improved infrastructure, Jigawa State launches into a new dawn of difference, distinguished by the translation of dividends of democracy into tangible, measurable, assured benefits in the lives of its people. With an all-inclusive approach to governance, emphasis on education, infrastructure, health, social security, and human capital development, the state is taking giant strides that have become an inevitable appeal to both local and foreign observers and investors.
Over the last 6 years, Jigawa State people have become used to receiving strangers in terms of people from outside coming in to partake in economic activities here. We are a very, very hospitable people. We welcome visitors. We have many visitors who have come for a few days but have changed their mind to remain with us. Investors are going to find Jigawa State more hospitable, more friendly, more secure than any part of this country that they are used to.
Jigawa has huge potentials for regional and international commerce and is indeed favored to play a leading role in the Nigerian economy. It is a key constituent of the Northern Nigeria economy and society. Located close to Nigeria's second largest city, Kano, with international links into the oil-rich Niger Republic. One of the pivotal thrusts of Dr. Sule Lamido's administration is its readiness to give all necessary support and cooperation to investors who want to invest in Jigawa State, and its willingness to work with any collaborator who would assist Jigawa to attain a better standing by meeting the need to harness the solid minerals lying idle.
We are willing to open up, to invite investors, our friends, and whoever to come to Jigawa, because we feel that in the last 6 years we'll be able to bring about the enabling environment. We are prepared to engage people. Let them come to our state, see our state with the huge potential in agriculture, in solid minerals, in small-scale industries, and a number of other things. They can see where they can really partake in the economic development of our state.
It was in appreciation of and in response to the issues of providing a forum for participants to identify broad policy options and develop strategies for mobilizing capital and investments that will help unlock the vast resources and potentials of the economy that an investment summit was initiated.
Jigawa State was crying for a repairer. Sule Lamido was ready, willing, able, and competent to do the job. Congratulations.
And so, the first Jigawa State Economic and Investment Summit, themed Mobilizing Investments for Sustainable Development, became much anticipated.
That summit gave birth to something new, something real, that yes, we can do it and we will get there.
Wednesday, 29th May 2013, saw the relative calm and erstwhile sleepy nature of Jigawa State shift to a very busy atmosphere with throng of eminent personalities from within and outside Nigeria. The day is a day originally set aside for the celebration of democracy in Nigeria. Did say the capital of Jigawa State was agog, with very important personalities from all over the country. The event was Jigawa's first ever economic and investment summit, organized by the state government, aimed at attracting investors from all over the globe. Dignitaries from all walks of life, bankers, entrepreneurs, business moguls, academics, and politicians were all in attendance. There were plenty of benefits accruing to the state by way of promises from local and international investors, aptly pleased to invest in the state, particularly since the state is relatively peaceful and governance is transparent, accountable, and friendly.
To all investors around the world, Jigawa is ready for you. The potentials are there. Whatever kind of industry you want to set up, this is just the beginning. Jigawa is the opening now for you.
The three-day event that took place from Wednesday 29th to Friday 31st of May 2013 was indeed a huge success. The government of Jigawa, headed by the indefatigable and visionary Sule Lamido, has sent out invitations to everyone that mattered in the trade and investment world.
We've been able to bring Jigawa from below sea level to sea level, and in so doing we're able to restore our vision and of course our honor and dignity.
According to the governor, the aim of organizing the summit was to chart a plan for developing Jigawa State economically at par with the Asian tigers like Japan and Singapore. Not in terms of big buildings, but for the state's people to attain good standard of living. Given the level and magnitude of attendance by leaders and captains of industry, Jigawa's invitation to all was no doubt well honored. The opening ceremony hosted an unprecedented turnout of the international community, giving credence to Jigawa's readiness to become a hub for commerce and industry. In attendance was Nigeria's former president, Olusegun Obasanjo, who delivered the keynote address.
Sule Lamido was virtually bundled up to be brought here. With the benefit of hindsight and with what I keep seeing when I come here, I'm happy that God gave me the ability to pressurize him and God gave him the ability to succumb to the pressure. He decided to put in place those essential things, physical and institutional, that must be put in place for a government to be able to function properly and well. Infrastructure that you have seen within the state capital and beyond. investment or calling people, mobilizing for investment from within and from without. You knew it was important, but first thing first. And I got the first thing to be done. And now he has reached the stage where he can beat his chest and say, let people come from within and from without to come and invest. And we get there. But I thank you for the way you have prioritized your work and your responsibility.
The desire to create a new world for the people of Jigawa State and to transform the state to an enduring and sustainable economic giant in Africa informed the governor's decision to initiate first a stakeholders meeting and then an economic summit of investors.
The state was virtually below sea level, or was literally delinking from the Federation.
When I took over government in 2007, the state was in total disrepair. I went around only to see that the state was in total squalor. I was overwhelmed by the enormity of the challenges that confronted me. But my ambition to make Jigawa a reference point in this country encouraged me not to be discouraged.
Whatever today we are, is something we owe to the state. Its contribution in getting us to our current position by giving us the right education, the upbringing, the concern, the care, the mentoring, and whatever. There was this groundswell, all of us, united, like I said, to save Jigawa from ourselves and also save ourselves from ourselves.
I strategically summoned a meeting of all the stakeholders in the state, including the professionals, business and political elites, the academia, the farmers, artisans, organized labor, students, and in fact, any group I thought could make any positive contribution to fashion out a pathway to develop the state and skip it from the discrepant situation that I found it in. After our brainstorming sessions at the stakeholders' meeting, we came to the understanding that we have all the resources, but human and material, to make a Dubai, Doha, or Singapore out of Jigawa State. We also resolved that we should build a state where citizens should see government as belonging to them and for their well-being, and government will see people as the reason it exists. We, however, realized that to do what we plan to do would require expensive capital injection. At a time when Jigawa State economy is largely informal, its real sector undiversified and foreign direct investment limited.
Today, we want to announce to the world, with all the noise we can muster, that we are ready and our doors are now open to take Jigawa to the next level. This informed the convening of this summit.
The Economic and Investment Summit focused mainly on four broad sectors, namely agriculture,
Nigeria has 84 million hectares of land, and that makes us one of the largest, people with the largest amount of land in Africa. We have water. You have 273 billion cubic meters of water. So we've got the land, we've got the water, we've got the cheap labor. Nigeria should be a powerhouse in food. You go to northern Nigeria today, you have massive and massive amount of rice that's been produced all the way from Sokoto down to Jigawa. The farmers produced 1.1 million metric tons of rice. Now that is one third of all the rice we need to be self-sufficient in rice by 2015.
The Economic and Investment Summit also focused on micro, small and medium enterprises and light manufacturing, solid minerals, commerce and services, including ICT. The presence of the member of UK's House of Lords and the British High Commissioner at the event, alongside various representatives of the international community, is a pointer of the faith Jigawa has garnered over the years. Others included Mr. Li, the Chinese investor who is establishing a giant footwear manufacturing company in Jigawa, Engineer Mansour Ahmed, DG Infrastructure Concession Regulatory Commission, Engineer Mustafa Bello, DG Nigeria Investment Promotion Council, among several others. The chairman of the occasion, Lord Boateng, in his speech, said Africans must imbibe the culture of investing in Africa because charity, which means love, must begin at home. A situation where Africans prefer to invest in Britain and other European countries will not encourage any foreign investment. About 60% of the population of the continent is youth in their productive ages. So government must invest in education and create enabling environments for the private sector to thrive. He commended the governor for putting up solid infrastructure which will eventually attract investors.
Nigeria is Africa's biggest destination for foreign direct investment. That's good, that's something to celebrate. And we want to see, as a result of this conference, the benefits of investing in Jigawa State known far and wide. But you know, we also need to recognize that Africa is above all the mother and father of its own progress, that we need to look to see how we can generate investment from within the country itself. Because all too often, when people amass wealth, the first thing they do is to think about how they can invest it outside. Well, of course, we like to see Nigerian investment in the UK. Thank you very much. And I'm sure His Excellency will join me in saying we would like some more of it. But let's not forget, charity. Charity begins at home. Charity means love. And we ought to be capable of loving ourselves and what Africa has to offer. Let us have in mind Agri's greatest saying, only the best is good enough for Africa. Only the best is good enough for Africa. Only the best is good enough for Jigawa State. Only the best is good enough for Africa.
Lord Boateng, in his speech, exuded great optimism and inspiration. He says the Jigawa dream is achievable.
Jigawa State, this state, your state, a state in which we have all convened for this purpose, can show Africa and the wider world the way to tackle people-centered development. Because this conference has at its heart the belief that it is only through maximizing the capacity, through realizing the potential of the people, that true democracy can be founded. It is only when each and every young person has a sense that their potential may be realized. It's only then that democracy is truly safe.
The summit held no less than 6 plenary sessions, with paper presentations by experts and opinion leaders to consider the different windows of opportunities for investing in Jigawa State. The third day saw the closing ceremony, where recommendations from the various sessions were read by Professor Mohammed Tabu.
Today's session is the closing session, and one of the main activities is to present the highlight of the discussions, debates, deliberations that we have had from the day before yesterday.
The deliberations were intended to complement and support the effort of the Sule Lamido administration as it strives to build a dynamic and competitive economy in its quest to reposition Jigawa as the preferred investment destination in northern Nigeria.
This summit had already been extremely successful from the first day. Jigawa State now has the kind of image that would give us no problem whatsoever to invite the kind of people of the caliber we require that will discharge the responsibilities that are necessary to push this state forward. And for that, we thank God very much.
The governors also directed the Ministry of Commerce and Industry to build a one-stop shop in the state for investors who can come to access information on investment and opportunities in the state.
The summit paved way for investors to have interest in the export processing zone, which is in Megatari and it's at the border between Nigeria and Niger. We have a very large cross-border trade with them. It's an opportunity that will create jobs for our teeming youth.
The British High Commissioner to Nigeria, Mr. Pocock, who launched the Jigawa State Investment Handbook, said the book was jointly produced by DFID and the state government in order to provide first-hand knowledge on investment opportunities in the state and the available resources in all the 27 local government areas. The High Commissioner said that the UK is happy with the development strides in the state, adding that the British government believes in private sector as the catalyst for development. Pocock added that the DFID recently donated hospital equipment worth 450 million naira to the state because of the commitment of the government to the health of its teeming population.
And I'm delighted to be able to say that looking at governments that have succeeded in doing this, they have certain things in common. Let me tell you what I think they are. First is the creation of good infrastructure. Second is maintaining a fair and transparent tax regime. Next is making it easy to register and to run a business, to eliminate corruption, and to offer secure property rights. Please, just let me finish. It's in exactly those areas that Jigawa State is making great strides, and it's why we intend to stay involved with Jigawa for the next 10 years.
To showcase the rich culture, norms, and values of the people of Jigawa State, the state organized a gala night in honor of the guests who attended the economic summit. State cultural troupe, Yamata Niger, Yanshantu, among others, clad in well-adorned outfits, performed at the occasion. It was indeed a rich cultural display.
Then you look at what's happening in Jigawa, and then you can now see that, yes, there's actually a major transformation.
As a show of commitment to supporting the Jigawa dream for a new world, Alhaji Dangote, who chaired the first plenary session on investment at the opening ceremony, made a commitment to create over 15,000 job opportunities.
I, for example, I will take one of the two or three projects which I said I should do. I think somewhere around Kogoma you have more than 20,000 hectares, and I can assure Your Excellency, we will build a 150,000 metric tons sugar plant.
Alhaji Dangote confirmed to the audience that he has finalized plans to build 150 metric tons sugar refinery in Kagama local government area of Jigawa State. He said the company would serve as a market for sugar cane producing farmers from the area.
Sugar business is an extremely very good business, not only for the money that you're going to make, but the passion is coming out that, look, you are providing quite a lot of jobs, and that gives you a lot of satisfaction. In the next 7 years, we'll be able to actually produce 2 million tons and creating well over 1.5 million jobs. You know, because in agriculture, almost everything is, you know, is highly, you know, labor intensive business. And today, if you go and open so many factories, whether it's cement or whatever, you don't actually create that much direct jobs like in agriculture. So agriculture, you know, is quite a lot. There's quite a lot that is happening. And, you know, the people will feel the impact. For example, you take over all the schools, you take over all the infrastructure, you take over water, you take over whatever it is, you take care of the community.
For Alhaji Ahmed Barde, a prospective investor, Will was sign an MOU with the state government on how to upgrade a 3-star hotel in Ditse to a 5-star hotel.
Rehabilitate, operate and transfer so that there will be a hotel in Jigawa that can take the kind of guests we have without the support from the government. Because most of the guests that come here, like the Richard Blackman, we go to the higher number than 5.
Jigawa State is a tourism haven with scenic charm which can attract more people if an international touch is added to the hotel. Buoyed by the foresight of the governor, Alhaji Sani Shehu, national president of the Miners Association of Nigeria, requested for details of the kaolin deposit in Jigawa to enable him to bring in people that will invest in the production of chalk, paint, and POP. Jigawa is surely and steadily marching towards the vision of the governor for a new world, even as the Nigerian Investment Promotion Commission and DFID pledge to support the state in the establishment of an investment promotion agency, while Messrs. Butake Resources PLC Lagos pledged to establish aviation handling services company at the new Ditse Airport under construction.
People who can otherwise travel to India, people who only people who travel to Egypt, can very happily come to Jigawa. If they come here, they will get Nigerian food, be treated by Nigerian doctors. If the state can build the infrastructure to build a hospital, I can assure you that we will bring in a team of doctors from India and who will do it without it being so expensive for patients who otherwise have to go and spend dollars.
Not to be left behind in the positive drive to put Jigawa on the map of the strong economies in Africa, Alhaji Dantata, the DG of Naiho Tours, promised to look at the possibility of establishing a hospitality training school in Jigawa. The representative of Diamond Bank, the official banker to the summit, Alhaji Muhammad Shuaibu Lawan, said a number of investors had indicated interest to invest in Jigawa.
We are committed and we're working with the state to ensure that this is a success in the state. Thank you.
Lee Group of Companies, a Chinese firm represented at the summit, equally reiterated commitment to the industrialization of the state through the footwear factory being established in Ringim local government area of Jigawa State. According to him, the civil works at the site will be completed by December 2013, while the installation of production machines will commence immediately and the plant will be commissioned and put into operation in May 2014. No doubt, a lot of work went into the preparation of the first economic and investment summit of Jigawa State. No doubt this first outing was a great success.
The success of the summit was so overwhelming for us. The right time has come.
Is this then a one-off event? Or are there plans to do this more regularly?
The governor made a promise to people and to the state to continue in the same spirit of dedication and hurry to make sure that this state continues with that drive to change life and landscape of the whole state.
To sustain the momentum after the summit, the governor immediately inaugurated a post-summit advisory council on economic development.
This summit must be distinguished by the commitment of the government to be able to enforce or to bring into reality what has been raised by way of recommendation or decisions. The steering committee, which worked to bring about the summit to that huge success, now metamorphosed or was transformed into an implementation committee, advising me and helping to respond to a number of ideas or questions raised by the investors. By this, we'll be able to maintain the momentum, to sustain the commitment, and show that, you know, yes, we are really serious.
And a one-stop shop for investments is created, where any investor who comes to Jigawa State can have access and all the support required to establish his business with the help of the committee.
This council is inaugurated and committed that to hit the ground running, as they say, so that we can try and assist the government in achieving its economic desires and help the people to change their life for the better and move the state forward so that it can become an example in Nigeria.
Distinguished members of the Advisory Council on Economic Management and Investment Promotion are Alhaji Bashir Dalhatu, Chairman, Alhaji Mustafa A. Tutse, MNI, Malam Rabiu Issa, Barrister Yakubu A. H. Ruba, Professor Haruna Wakili, Malam Yusuf Kazaure, Adamu Mohammed Garun Gabas, YZ Yao, Babandi Ibrahim, Dr. Ahmed M. Falaki, Professor Mohammed Tabiu, Engineer Mansur Ahmed, Engineer Habu Gumel, Dr. Mohammed Sagagi, Haja H.L. Bafa, Haja Umma A. Dutse. This council has been given its terms of reference and has commenced work on furthering the outcome of the summit, and its recommendations are to become a blueprint of sort ready for implementation, subject to the governor's approval and ratification. Jigawa State is known for tolerance to all faiths and sects exercising their religious obligation. Exactly a week after their very successful summit, Dutse, the Jigawa state capital, literally stood still for yet another grand event. Their grand event, marking the Mulud celebration of late Sheikh Ibrahim Iyas al-Kaulahi. An estimated 3 million people converged at the event that took place at the famous Aminu Kano Triangle, as a massive crowd came from within and outside Nigeria to grace the occasion, a scene reminiscent of the famous Arafat. Dutse literally grinded to a halt with human and vehicular traffic. All entry points to Dutse, especially Wudil, which is about 40 minutes drive to Dutse town, and Kwana Huguma, were completely choked up. Hosted by Governor Sule Lamido, in attendance were royal and spiritual fathers, and the special guest of honor was the Speaker of the Federal House of Representatives, Right Honorable Aminu Tambuwal, amongst other several political bigwigs, Islamic scholars, and so on. In a quick succession, similar event of Izala sect were also hosted by Jigawa State, all geared toward a peaceful, prosperous, spiritual state where everyone have equal opportunity of worship and religion. Jigawa is indeed living up to its slogan, a new world, a once sleepy state, is positively transforming. Indeed, the gateway is open to the new investors, to a bold new world. A world envisioned in the mold of the Asian tigers, but propelled by the vision of Dr. Sule Lamido, a whole new world for Jigawa State. Let's embrace it as we set forth a legacy for the people. This is why we ask and implore you to join us as partners in progress and invest in our emerging world so that we can have a positive future together.
For new partners that are looking for opportunities, Jigawa is the state.
Jigawa State, igniting the power of a new world.